الحمد لله يا رب العالمين، صلى الله وسلم على محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. We are still studying, بارك الله فيكم, these three ties from the two imams, the imams of أهل السنة. الإمام أبو حاتم الرازي رحمه الله and الإمام أبو زرع الرازي رحمه الله and also the son of الإمام أبو حاتم الرازي عبد الرحمن ابن أبي حاتم الرازي. So in these three ties, these imams, they mention the عقيدة of أهل السنة, the aqeedah of the people of the Sunnah from the righteous predecessors. Meaning that this is the belief the Messenger of Allah was upon and his companions were upon and those who came after them and followed them in goodness. And from this belief, he said, وَالْبَعْتُ مِنْ بَعْدِ الْمَوْتِ حَقِّ and the resurrection after death is true. So we must believe that Allah resurrect the bodies. After they die, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bring them back to life. And that's why it's called Yawm al-Qiyamah, the day of resurrection. Because it is the day Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala resurrect the souls and the bodies. So He brings them back to life. The Sheikh said, وَهُوَ رُكْنٌ مِنْ أَرْكَانِ الْإِيمَانِ السِّتَّةِ الَّتِي لَا يَتِمُّ إِيمَانُ عَبْدٍ إِلَّا بِهِمَا جَمِيعًا. The Sheikh said that it is from one of the pillars, from the six pillars of Iman. Because when Jibreel, عليه السلام, he asked the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about Islam. He said, Islam is that you bear witness that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah. And that Muhammad is the Messenger of Allah. And that you establish the Salat. And that you give the Zakat. And you fast the month of Ramadan. And you perform the Hajj if you have the ability to do so. Then he said, tell me about al-Iman. Then he said, al-Iman is to believe in Allah, to believe in His angels, to believe in His books, to believe in His messengers, to believe in the last day. The last day, this is the point of reference. The last day means the day of resurrection. And to believe in al-qadr, predestination, good and bad. So you have to accept all of it. Sometimes it may not be good, but you have to accept the qadr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And there is nothing that Allah decrees except that there is khair in it. What you don't like is good for you. So he said, Rahimahullah, Sheikh Zayd ibn Muhammad ibn Hadi al-Madkhali rahimahullah ta'ala, he said that the belief of a Muslim cannot be completed without them, without believing in these arkan, these pillars, the six pillars of al-Iman, and one of them is to believe in the resurrection. The Sheikh, he said, وَمَنْ أَنْكَرَ الْبَعْتَ أو شك فيه فقد كفر كفرا أكبر يخرج من الملة. He said, whoever disbelieves in the resurrection, whoever disbelieves in the resurrection or doubts it, so either he disbelieves altogether or he has doubt about it, then this person exits the fold of Islam altogether. May Allah protect us from that. So this person becomes what? A disbeliever. An apostate. He apostated from الإسلام، لأن الله عز وجل أخبر بذلك في آيات متعددة. Because Allah has informed us about the resurrection in various آيات of the Quran. Like the statement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَاتَّقُوا يَوْمًا تُرْجَعُونَ فِيهِ إِلَى اللَّهِ سورة البقرة. And fear a day in which you will return back to Allah. Fear a day in which you will return back to Allah. So be aware of that day, the day of resurrection, because it's coming. And we should fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because that day is a decisive day. Either you are from the people of Jannah or you are from the people of Hellfire. So a person should fear Allah, should have that awe and fear in his heart that he will meet his Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Shaykh, he said, وَهُوَ يَوْمُ الْبَعْثِ وَالنُّشُورِ. And it is the day where the people will be resurrected. It is the day of resurrection. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, يَوْمَ تُبْلَى السَّرَائِرِ Surah Tariq. On the day where the secret will be made open. Those things that you hide in your chest, they will be made open. Because he knows everything, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He knows what you keep in your heart of secrets, and he knows what you do in public. أَيُكْشَفُ عَنِ الْأُمُورِ. Shaykh, he said that the affairs will be made open. The affairs will be manifested. الْمَخْبَأُ فِي الدُّنْيَا يُكْشَفُ عَنْهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. الْمُخَبَّأُ فِي الدُّنْيَا يُكْشَفُ عَنْهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. What you conceal in this world will be made open in the next world. Will be made open on the day of resurrection. And the Shaykh, he mentioned ayat from the Quran, Surah Al-Qiyamah, Surah Al-Nazi'at, and the like, that speaks about the day of the judgment. Speak about the day of the judgment and the day of resurrection. The Shaykh, he said, فَوَعَدَ اللَّهُ فَوَعَدُ اللَّهِ حَقٌّ وَهُوَ مَجِيءُ الْقِيَامَةِ وَالْجَزَاءِ لِلْأَعْمَالِ. He said, the promise of Allah is true, that the day of resurrection will take place. That the day of resurrection will take place. And also the recompense will take place for good and bad, for good deeds and bad deeds. He said, وَكَمَا أَخْبَرَ عَلَيْهِ الصَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ إِنَّكُمْ تُحْشَرُونَ إِلَى رَبِّكُمْ حُفَاتٍ عُرَاتٍ غُرْلًا وَفِي رِوَايَةٍ بُهْمًا. So he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you will surely be resurrected in front of your Lord naked. And there is a narration, Aisha radiallahu anha asked the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and she said, O Messenger of Allah, men and women will be naked looking at each other. Then the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, the matter is much greater than that. So they wouldn't have the time to be looking at each other. Because at that time you will be worrying about yourself. Not going to worry about your dad, your mom, your wife, your sibling and the like. You have to worry about yourself. As Allah said in the Quran, the day where man will run away from his relatives. So that's why we have to take advantage of the time we have in this world. The more you breathe, the more opportunities you have. Because when you die, that's it. Life does not rewind. So you have to do the good deed here and prepare yourself for the hereafter. As one of the Salaf, Dawood al-Ta'i, rahimahullah, and he was a scholar who occupied himself with the affair of the hereafter. He was busy preparing himself for the hereafter. So a man followed him and he said, may Allah have mercy upon you. Can you give me an advice? He said, woe to you. Woe to you. Fast this world and break the fast in the hereafter. Fast this world and break the fast in the hereafter. So we have to think about this affair that one day we're going to die. And it can happen any time. You may die in your sleep. You may die in an accident. Anything can happen to you. So you have to be prepared. There was a question to the Sheikh. اختلاف الصحابة في بعض المسائل يسمى اختلاف تنوع واختلاف أفهام. A person asked the Sheikh about the difference of the companions رضي الله عنهم. Is it a difference of diversity or a difference of understanding that each one understand it certain way and the like? The Sheikh, he said, نعم اختلاف تنوع. It is a different of diversity. A different of diversity. وقد يكون خلاف تضاد في الفروع في المسائل العملية. He said sometimes it could be some opinions that conflict with each other when it comes to the issues of الفقه. When it comes to the issues of الفقه. That's why you have four madahib. That's why you have four madahib. You have the madhab of Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah, madhab of Imam Malik, Imam Shafi'i, Imam Ahmed, and the other Imams, Sufyan ibn Sa'id al-Tawri, Sufyan ibn Uyayna, Al-Layth ibn Sa'd, Imam Al-Awza'i, and others from the Imams of the Salaf. So they differ in certain issues of al-fiqh. طيب. The Sheikh said, أَمَّا فِي الْأُصُولِ فَإِنَّهُمْ لَا يَخْتَلِفُونَ. He said, as far as the fundamental principle, they don't differ in those. The fundamental principle means العقيدة. أصول الدين. The fundamental principle of the deen means that the deen is based upon الإيمان. توحيد. العقيدة. They're all the same. Sheikh Al-Fawzan mentioned. They're all the same. So the fundamental principle of the deen means the al-aqidah. The sahaba, they will never differ in aqidah. They will never differ in aqidah. Now, if someone says, well, what about what you say about the statement of Abdullah ibn Abbas versus the statement of the mother of the believers, Aisha radiallahu anha? Because you know the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was asked when he came back from al-Isra wal-Mi'raj, the ascension to the heaven. Abu Dharr al-Ghifari radiallahu anhu, he asked him. He said, O Messenger of Allah, have you seen your Lord? So he said, Nurun anna arah. Meaning that his light is his hijab. His screen is light. How can I see him? So he did not see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because no one can see Allah in this world. Allah will be seen in the next world, thereafter, but not in this world. And if that was possible, then Musa would have seen him. And also Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would have seen him. So Aisha radiallahu anha, she said, whoever claims that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had seen his Lord, then he had fabricated a lie against Allah. He had fabricated a lie against Allah. Because Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he did not see his Lord. طيب. Now, this is the statement of Aisha radiallahu anha. Abdullah ibn Abbas, he said, رآه بقلبه. He saw him with his heart. Is there any contradiction between the statement of Aisha radiallahu anha and the statement of Abdullah ibn Abbas? Is there any contradiction between them? There is no contradiction. Because he did not say he saw him with his eyes. He saw him with his heart. طيب. So there is no, alhamdulillah, difference of opinion among the Sahaba when it comes to the affairs of belief. Yes, in the affairs of al-fiqh, salat, zakat, and other than that, you find that there is difference of opinion among the companions, radiallahu anhum wa ardahum. طيب. The Shaykh, he said, رحمه الله تعالى, لا يختلف الصحابة ولا أئمة العلم, لكن في العمليات يحصل الخلاف. He said, as far as the creed, the Sahaba, the Tabi'een, أتباع التابعين, the Imams of knowledge, like Abu Hanifa, Malik, Shafi, Ahmed, Sufyan ibn Uyayna, Sufyan al-Thawri, and others, until the, you know, our generation, Sheikh bin Baz, Sheikh Uthaymeen, Sheikh Saleh al-Fawzan, Sheikh Saleh al-Luhaydan, and others, they will not differ when it comes to al-Aqidah. There is no difference of opinion among them. But in al-amaliyat, al-amaliyat are things that practical matters, like al-fiqh. Because you do it, it's a practical thing. You make wudu, salat, zakat, and other than that. So these are called al-amaliyat, because these are practical matters. There is difference of opinion among the scholars. You find some of the scholars, they say, for example, this is permissible. Another scholar said no. Or someone says it's highly recommended. Someone says wajib or the like. There's nothing wrong with that. Like, for example, I'll give you an example. The Prophet ﷺ, he said, العهد الذي بيننا وبينهم الصلاة فمن تركها فقد كفر. The criterion that divides us Muslims from non-Muslims is the salat. So whoever abandons the salat, then he has committed what? Kufr. Some scholars, they understood from this hadith, whoever abandons the salat altogether, he does not pray, period. He does not pray. Fajr, Dhuhr, Asr, Maghrib, Isha, Al-Jumu'ah, nothing, zero. So they say this person is a kafir. Okay? Others, they understood it differently. Like Sheikh bin Baz, for example. They said whoever leaves a salat, even if it is one salat. For example, Sheikh bin Baz, rahimahullah, he was asked about a man who intentionally slept until the sun was rising. What is the ruling of this man? He said, this man is a kafir. He's a disbeliever. Because he intentionally abandoned the salat. And you know, subhanallah, it's very dangerous because the hadith did not specify. Did not say whoever abandons the salat altogether. He said whoever abandons the salat. Abandons. And this is unrestricted. So it could be some of the salat. It could be all the salat. So why do you want to take, you know, a risk? Wal-iyadu billah. We should not be lax when it comes to the salat. May Allah protect us from al-kufr. Tayyib. Then inshallah ta'ala we're going to go to the next principle. وَقَالَ وَأَهْلُ الْكَبَائِرِ فِي مَشِيئَةِ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلْ And they said, both of them said, meaning Al-Imam Abu Hatim al-Razi, Al-Imam Abu Zur'a al-Razi. They said, and the people of al-Kabair, the people of al-Kabair, meaning the Muslims who commit major sins. Major sins like devouring riba is a major sin. Fornicating. This is also a major sin. طيب. So all these are major sin. Gambling, backbiting, slandering, all these are major sin. طيب. So these individuals, they said that they are under the will of Allah. They are under the will of Allah. If Allah wills, He will forgive them. If Allah wills, He will punish them. And you must understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from His name, is the All Just. He does not oppress anyone. فَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ خَيْرًا يَرَهُ وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ شَرًّا يَرَهُ. Whoever does an atom's weight of good shall see it. Whoever does an atom's weight of evil shall see it. So he will not oppress anyone. So those who commit major sin, some of them, because of a tawheed that they have with them, or they have done certain deeds that pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He let them go because of those good deeds that they have done. طيب. Like, for example, the woman prostitute from the children of Israel. And prostitution is a major sin. It's evil. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgave this woman because she was compassionate towards a dog who was extremely thirsty. So she gave him water and Allah forgave her. You see? It could be a good deed that you have done. Don't you ever underestimate a good deed. It could be a sadaqah. But look what the Prophet ﷺ said in the hadith about sadaqah. He said, تصدقوا ولو بعدل تمرح. He said, give sadaqah even if it is the size of a date. And then he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and give it from halal, means that it was lawfully earned. Because Allah will not accept that which is pure and halal. And then he said, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make it grow for the person. He will increase it in size, so much so that it will become like a mountain. Allahu Akbar. Small good deed that you have done. But because ikhlas, sincerity, that you have done it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You did not do it to show off. You did not do it seeking fame, seeking reputation. No. You do it only for the sake of Allah. And that's why those who do for the sake of Allah, you would not even know that they have done it. You would not even know. And how many people, they don't want their name to be known to the people. No, don't mention my name. He gives fi sabilillah and that's it. Because he knows Allah sees everything. Why does his name to be out there? Like some people, they build masajid and they put their name on the masjid. Why do you put your name on the masjid? Subhanallah. May Allah grant us ikhlas. The Shaykh, he said, after he sent the peace and blessing on the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, من معتقد أهل السنة والجماعة أن أهل الكبائر الذين أسرفوا على أنفسهم وهم من أهل التوحيد والصلاة أنهم تحت مشيئة الله عز وجل إن شاء عفى عنهم فلم يدخلهم النار وإن شاء أدخلهم إلى النار بقدر ذنوبهم ومآلهم إلى الجنة. The Shaykh, he said, rahimahullah ta'ala, look, subhanallah, Shaykh Zayd ibn Muhammad ibn Hadi al-Madkhali, he passed away a few years ago. Look at his knowledge now. We are reading from his explanation, and the Shaykh is getting the reward, getting the tawab. This is what we call beneficial knowledge. Beneficial knowledge. The Shaykh, rahimahullah ta'ala, he said, from the belief of the people of the Sunnah, that the people who commit major sins from among the Muslims, those who have done so many sins, they have gone over the limits of committing sins. And they are from the people of Tawheed. So they are from the people of La ilaha illallah, and they are also the people of the Salat. And the Shaykh, he mentioned the Salat. Why? Because of the Hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Al-ahdu alladhi baynana wa baynahum as-salat, faman taraka faqad kafar. The criterion that divides us Muslims from non-Muslims is the Salat. Whoever abandons the Salat, then he has committed kufr. So that's why the Shaykh, he mentioned Tawheed and the Salat also. So these individuals, they are under the will of Allah. If Allah wills, He forgives them, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And He does not enter them into the hellfire. And if He wills, He will enter them into the hellfire according to their sins. According to their sins. But their outcome will be al-Jannah. The outcome will be that they will be going to al-Jannah at the end. بفضل الله عز وجل ثم بشفاعة الشافعين. And they will enter al-Jannah by the grace of Allah, by His grace and mercy, subhanahu wa ta'ala, or by the intercession of the intercessors, like the prophet and messengers, like the angels, the righteous people. They will intercede for them. They will intercede for them to come out. إذن أن الله يأذن في الشفاعة للموحدين فتشفع الملائكة ويشفع الرسل والأنبياء ويشفع المؤمنون حتى لا يبقى في النار أحد من أهل التوحيد والصلاة. He said that the people of Tawheed, the people of Tawheed means those who single out Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in His lordship, in His worship, and His named attributes. He said, these individuals, if they enter the hellfire because of the major sin that they have committed, and Allah did not forgive them, then the angels, alayhim as-salam, they will intercede for them. The angels will intercede for them. Or the messengers, and the prophet and messengers, they will intercede for them. And the believers also will intercede for them until none of the people of Tawheed remains in the hellfire. The people of Tawheed and Salat. وَهَذَا هُوَ مُعْتَقَدُ أَهْلِ السُّنَّةِ وَالْجَمَاعَةِ. And this is the belief of أهل السنة والجماعة. This is what they are upon. They believe that those who commit major sin, they are under the will of Allah. If Allah wills, He will forgive them and He will not punish them. If Allah wills, He will punish them. But at the end, they will come out by the grace of Allah and His mercy, or by way of intercession. By way of intercession. The Shaykh said, فَلَيْسُوا كَالْخَوَارِجِ وَالْمُعْتَزِلَةِ. So the people of the Sunnah, they believe that those who commit major sin, they will be under the will of Allah. And also, they will come out of the hellfire after they're punished, either by the grace of Allah and His mercy, or by the intercessors, by the intercession of the intercessors. He said, unlike al-Khawarij wal-Mu'tazila, because al-Khawarij wal-Mu'tazila, they believe that the one who commits a major sin is what? He's a kafir. They say he's a disbeliever. So they don't believe that there will be any intercession for him, because the intercession is only for the believers. So if they believe that the one who commits major sin is a disbeliever, then of course there is no intercession for him. This is the belief of al-Khawarij wal-Mu'tazila. Of course this is incorrect. طائفتان من الطوائف الهالكة قالوا بخلود عصاة الموحدين في النار. So these are two destructive and deviant sects. Al-Khawarij and Mu'tazila. They are of the opinion that those who commit major sin, they will be in the fire forever. Allah protect us. This is extreme. This is extreme. إذ عندهم من ارتكب كبيرة ومات ولم يتب ولو كان من أهل التوحيد والصلاة والصيام والزكاة والحج وغيرهما فهو عندهم خالد مخلد في النار. أعوذ بالله. So الخوارج المعتزلة, they hold that opinion and that belief that the one who commits a major sin from the people of Tawheed, even if he is a man who performed the salat and give the zakat, fast the month of Ramadan, he performed hajj, he does all that, once he commits a major sin, according to them, this man will be in the hellfire forever. This is what we call extremism. Ghulu. This is ghulu. This is extremism. طيب. The Shaykh said, فَتَحَجَّرُوا وَاسِعًا وَاللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلْ وَاسِعُ الْمَغْفِرَةِ لِمَنْ يَسْتَحِقُّ الْمَغْفِرَةَ مِنْ أَهْلِ التَّوْحِيدِ وَالصَّلَاةِ الَّذِينَ مَاتُوا عَلَى الْكُفْرِ الْأَكْبَرِ وَالشِّرْكِ الْأَكْبَرِ وَالنِّفَاقِ الْاَعْتِقَادِ الَّذِينَ مَا مَاتُوا عَلَى الْكُفْرِ وَالْأَكْبَرِ والشرك الأكبر والنفاق الاعتقادي. So the Shaykh said, الخوارج والمعتزلة حجروا واسعا, meaning that they have made the mercy of Allah narrow. They have made the mercy of Allah narrow because the mercy of Allah is vast. The mercy of Allah is vast. It encompasses also the sinners as long as they are the people of Tawheed. They are the people of Tawheed. They don't associate partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And their Tawheed is good. And they performed the Salat. They gave the Zakat. They fasted the month of Ramadan. And they performed the Hajj wal Umrah and the like. And they gave Sadaqat and the like. But they committed major sins. So these individuals, they will be under the mercy of Allah. Allah will have mercy upon them. And they will be taken out from the hellfire if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wills to punish them. Al-Khawarij said no, they will be in the hellfire. Al-Iyadu Billah. How can they be in the hellfire with the kuffar wal mushrikeen? Shaykh, he said, وَإِنَّمَا مَاتُوا عَلَى التَّوْحِيدِ وَعَلَى شَعَائِرِ الْإِسْلَامِ. He said, this individual, they did not die upon major kufr, major shirk, and major nifaq. They did not die upon that. They died upon tawheed. They died upon at-tawheed, and also they died upon shara'i' al-Islam, meaning that they have implemented the sharia, salat, zakat, and other than that. Su'al. الآية يا أيها الذين آمنوا أطيعوا الله وأطيعوا الرسول ولا تبطلوا أعمالكم. So a person asked the Shaykh in Surah Muhammad, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, O you who believe, obey Allah and obey the Messenger, and do not render your deeds fruitless. Do not render your deeds fruitless. So the person is asking the Shaykh, what does it mean by rendering the deeds fruitless? The Shaykh said, إبطالها بمعنى إبطال ثوابها وذلك بأنواع وأسباب. He said, rendering it fruitless, it doesn't mean that the deed will not be accepted. It means that he will not get rewarded. I'll give an example. A person, he comes late on Yom Al-Jumu'ah. And he did it intentionally. طيب. First of all, this person is sinning because his intention is wrong. So when he came, the imam was done with the salat. So this person, he will not be rewarded for Al-Jumu'ah, and also the Salat Al-Jumu'ah. He will not be rewarded for that. So he has to pay what? He has to pray ظهر. So he will not get the reward. طيب, another example. Someone fasted during Ramadan, but he backbites others, or he slanders others, or he lies and the like. So this person, he may be deprived of reward. Or at least, the least that can be said about this person, that his reward will be diminished. His reward will be diminished because he did not fast as he's supposed to fast. طيب. The Sheikh said, منها أنه أن يشرع الرجل في عبادة فيتركها بدون عذر هذا إبطال. He said, for example, if a person, he initiates an act of worship, then he abandons it without any excuse. This is rendering your deeds fruitless. ومنها أن يتصدق بصدقة لا يخلص فيها وهذا إبطال التواب. And also, a person gives sadaqah, but he doesn't have ikhlas. He's doing it to show off or the like. Then this person, he will not get the tawab, the reward of that sadaqah. ليس المراد إلا ذلك, بل كل سبب يبطل به تواب العبادات وتبطل به العبادة نفسها فهو داخل تحت الآية. He said, any reason that nullifies the action and the reward of that action enters into the ayah. ولا تبطلوا أعمالكم, and do not render your deeds fruitless. أي لا تسببوا في بطلانها أو بطلان ثوابها. Meaning, do not be a mean for that action to be null void, or that you will not get the tawab from that action. So you have to be very careful when you worship Allah. Make sure that you have ikhlas, that you do it only for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قال المؤلف رحمه الله ولا نكفر أحدا من أهل القبلة بذنوبهم ونكل سرائرهم إلى الله عز وجل. And they said, and we don't deem anyone from the people of Qibla, the people of Qibla, the Muslims, because they face the Qibla, like everyone else. So we don't deem the people of Qibla, the Muslims, we don't deem them to be non-believers because of their sins, like al-Khawarij. We don't deem them to be non-believers due to their sins. Rather, we leave their affair to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. هذا معتقد أهل السنة والجماعة أنهم لا يكفرون أهل القبلة بذنوبهم. This is the belief of the people of the Sunnah, that they don't deem those who face the Qibla in the Salat among the Muslims, they don't deem them to be non-believers due to their sins. والمراد بأهل القبلة الموحدين الذين وحدوا الله عز وجل وأقاموا فرائده. The Sheikh, he said, and what is intended by the people of the Qibla are the people of Tawheed, those who testify that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah. These are al-muwahideen, those who singled out Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in His lordship, in His worship, in His name and attributes, and also the established al-fara'id, what Allah has obligated upon them. مهما ارتكبوا من الذنوب والكبائر والصغائر. No matter how much of the sins they have committed, whether they are major sins or minor sins. فإن أهل السنة والجماعة لا يحكمون على أحد منهم بالكفر ولو مات على ذلك. So the people of the Sunnah, they don't deem anyone from the people of Tawheed to be a disbeliever, even if he dies committing a major sin. We don't say this person is a kafir. Even those who commit suicide, they are still Ahl al-Tawheed. They're still Ahl al-Tawheed. Yes, they have weakness in their iman. But those that commit suicide and they kill themselves among the Muslims, We still give them their rights in terms of washing their body and performing janazah on them, but they are not kuffar. Yes, they have deficiency in their iman. Yes, they do. They have deficiency in their iman because they were not patient to deal with the painful decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because the decree of Allah can be painful sometimes. You have to be patient. You lose a loved one, something like that. طيب. But we don't make takfir of them. We don't take them out of the fold of Islam. As long as they are the people of التوحيد. ولكن أهل السنة والجماعة يرجون للمحسنين ويخافون على المسيء. But the people of the Sunnah, they hope good. And they think good about those who do good. That inshallah, بإذن الله, they will be in Jannah. But they will not say definitely this person is going to be in Jannah. No, because you don't know. But they hope and they think good about that person that inshallah he will be from among the people of Jannah. And that at the same time, they fear for those who commit major sin, they fear for them. الشيخ said, والعصاة تحت مشيئة الله كما سبق. And those among the sinners, they are under the will of Allah. If Allah wills, He will punish them. If Allah wills, He will not punish them, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He will forgive them. ولكن ولا يكون خالدا في النار إلا الكفار والمشركين والمنافقين نفاقا اعتقاديا. He said, only the people of al-kufr, major kufr, al-kuffar, and also al-mushrikeen, the polytheists, and the munafiqeen, those who have al-nifaq al-aqadi, nifaq of belief. They manifest al-iman on their tongue, but they hide the kufr in their heart. والملحدون الذين يخرجهم إلحادهم من الملة. And likewise, the atheist, those who don't believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they deny that Allah exists, those are also with al-kuffar wal-mushrikeen. وَأَمَّا عُصَاتِ الْمُوَحِّدِينَ فَلَا يَجُوزُ لِأَحَدٍ أَنْ يُكَفِّرَهُمْ بِذُنُوبٍ دُونَ الشِّرْكِ بِاللَّهِ. He said, as far as the sinners among the Muslims and among the people of Tawheed, those who committed major sins, then it is not permissible for anyone to take them out of the fold of Islam and to deem them to be kuffar, as long as they have not committed shirk. فَمَنْ فَعَلَ ذَلِكَ فَقَدْ سَلَكَ مَسْلَكَ الْمُعْتَزِلَةِ وَالْخَوَارِجِ. So whoever says that they are kuffar, then he is following the way and the methodology of al-khawarij wal-mu'tazila, because this is their belief. لأنهم هم الذين يكفرون بالذنوب, because they are the one who deem those who commit major sin to be kuffar. أما الخوارج فيحكمون على مرتكب الكبائر بالكفر في الدنيا والآخرة. As for الخوارج, they deem those who commit major sin to be kuffar in this world, and also they are kuffar in the next world. So in this world means if they are kuffar, then they will not be given a proper washing, they will not be buried in the Muslim graveyard and the like, and in the hereafter they say they are kuffar. في الدنيا كافر حلال الدم والمال. So in this dunya he is a disbeliever, his blood is halal to shed والعياذ بالله, and his wealth is halal to be taken from him. خوارج. وفي الآخرة يكون خالدا مخلدا في النار إذا مات بدون توبة. And in the hereafter, he will be in the hellfire forever if he does not make tawbah. والمعتزلة يخالفونهم في الحكم الدنيوي فيقولون هو في الدنيا في منزلة بين المنزلتين, والمراد بالمنزلتين الكفر والإيمان. وأما في الآخرة فيتفقون مع الخوارج بالقول بخلود عصاة الموحدين في النار. So المعتزله in this dunya they have a very strange ruling upon those who commit major sin. they said, we don't give them the title of Iman, and we don't give them the title of Kufr, then what are they? What are they if then we don't give them the title of Iman and title of Kufr? This is in this dunya. But as far as the ruling in the hereafter, they agree with the Khawarij. They will be in the hellfire. وَهَؤُلَاءِ فَارَقُوا أَهْلَ السُّنَّةِ وَقَالُوا عَلَى اللَّهِ بِغَيْرِ عِلْمٍ. And these are the ones who separated and divided from the people of the Sunnah, and they spoke about Allah without knowledge. فَارْتَكَبُوا ذَنْبًا عَظِيمًا وَتَحَجَّرُوا وَاسِعًا. They have committed a tremendous sin because they spoke without knowledge, and also they made the mercy of Allah narrow. They made the mercy of Allah narrow. وَتَرَكُوا الْقَوْلَ بِالنُّصُوصِ الَّتِي فِيهَا الْجَمْعِ بَيْنَ نُصُوصِ الْوَعْدِ وَالْوَعِيدِ. And they left the texts that in the Quran, those texts that have a warning, and those texts that there is a bishara, glad tidings. If you do this, you will go to Jannah. These are الْوَعْدِ وَالْوَعِيدِ. فَبَطَلَ قَوْلُهُمْ واستقام قول أهل السنة والجماعة الذين أخذوا بجميع النصوص وجمعوا بين نصوص الوعد والوعيد. So the statement of الخوارج المعتزلة has been nullified and they are false, and الحمد لله the people of the Sunnah, they are correct, because the people of the Sunnah, they took the text from القرآن والسنة, and they gathered the text, because if you don't gather the text, you will not be able to see, you will not be able to get the ruling. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us all al-ilm al-nafi' wal-amal al-salih. Alhamdulillah rabbil alameen. Sallallahu ala Muhammadin wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallim.